everybody, Robert G. Robert here. Welcome to the show. Well, it's, as you know, I'm a very good friend of the Care Bears, especially my good buddy Tenderheart Bear. But as you know, Tenderheart is just one part of the Care Bears family, and today I have a very special guest who is another important part of those lovable friends of mine who share feelings and caring all over the world. But he's also like one of the probably the least known Care Bears in the family. So it is my honor and pleasure to present today my friend here, Bedtime Bear of the Care Bears.
Hi, everybody. How are you?
Oh, hi, Bedtime Bear. So nice to see you. Nice to meet you finally up close and personal.
Good to see you too, Rabbit.
Yeah, you know, I'm good buddies with Tenderheart Bear, and we see each other all the time, and we do special things together and everything. And, you know, like I said, people hardly see you around, except, or at least not in daylight, are they?
Yeah, people have a hard time seeing me because I'm usually working all night long while all of you guys are sleeping. My job is to help you guys have sweet dreams at night.
Ah, that's right. So you're sort of like Carolot's night crew, aren't you?
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's really sweet, huh? So, Clody, do you actually move around in Dreamland and,
Yes, I do. In fact, the other night I was helping Grumpy Bear. He was having an issue working on his new carrying rescue beam.
Oh, yeah, his transporter rescue. Yes, uh-huh. But at night, was he working on it that late?
He was in his dreams. He wasn't figuring out the right way to do things, but I was able to give him a couple of good ideas, and then he was able to finish it.
When he was awake.
Yes.
Uh-huh. That's right. Yeah, that's right. You really sleep in the daytime, which is why when everybody sees you, you look like you're so dozy, right?
But
you're
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're really up wide awake at night, right, when everybody else is asleep.
I'm a true night owl.
Ah, or night bear, huh? Yeah, uh-huh. Well, anyway, so as you know, Tenderheart Bear and I, we actually do a lot of events together, or at least I go see some of the things he does in New York and town in the daytime. In fact, recently, you know, the Care Bears were in New York very recently, at least two of them. I saw Grumpy Bear and Cheer Bear at Macy's.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they were at the flower show.
Oh, what was that like?
Oh, that was kind of fun. And then they were there as part of the pet fair. In fact, you know, we have some video about it if you will go watch. You see?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, look at it. See, they're outside in front of the big Macy's store in New York City, where they also appear in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade every year.
And we just sponsored a garden for the Macy's Garden Show.
Oh,
happened to see that?
Oh, yes, that's right. I think it was the flower show. It was upstairs in the kids' clothing department, and they had this nice little garden there. It had mm-hmm. Care Bear sponsored it, and had it was smaller than I thought, actually. In fact, I had to run all over the store trying to find it, because I kept walking by it, but I eventually did find it, and that's right, there's some pictures of it. Look at that. And, here's something else. I said Grumpy Bear and Cheer Bear were at the Macy's flower show recently, and then here's a shot of Grumpy Bear actually dancing in the flower show on the 7th floor. Isn't he such a silly dancer?
He's such a funny dancer.
Yeah, I know. Is that the way a grumpy person dances?
I guess so.
Yeah, that's me. Come on, go, Grumpy, go! I remember seeing all of you Care Bears in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade way back in, like, the mid-1980s.
You know, I was in the Macy's Day Parade one year.
You were actually in it three times.
Yes, I was.
That's right. You were in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade back in 1983, 84, and 85.
My favorite was in 85 when I got to ride on my moon.
Oh, yes, right. You got to ride on the moon.
Mm-hmm.
That was, it almost looked like one of those kitty quarter horse rides that I like, you know? Except you didn't have to put a quarter in, did you?
No, I didn't have to do that.
Yeah, but you were like flying down Central Park West and Broadway with all those people cheering and waving to you and everything. Yeah.
Yep, I have lots of fans, as do you.
Oh, I do? Oh, really? I think I do. I wish I heard from them a little more, but I know Tenderheart's one of them.
Yeah, he's a good friend of mine. He talks very highly about you.
Oh, really? Oh, that's so caring and sweet of him, huh? Mm-hmm. These past couple of years, you've been back again. I know you were gone for a long time, but it's good to see you back there, right? I saw Grumpy Bear, and I saw Funshine Bear, and Cheer Bear, and Oopsie Bear. I remember way back 20 years ago, you know, when, well, let's see, you weren't there, but a whole bunch of the Care Bears were appearing at Dorney Park in Allentown, Pennsylvania years ago.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. There was Cheer Bear, Good Luck Bear, and Friend Bear was there. And Wish Bear, too. Braveheart Lion was there, Care Bear cousin, you know. Yeah, right.
Braveheart, good friend of mine.
Right, that's right. Yes, they were all at Dorney Park 20, hard to believe that was 20 years ago.
Don't be sad if the sun don't shine. Don't be sad if there ain't no clouds.
Every day is a beautiful day when you have a friend.
Give a little hug and give a little loving.
Give a little care and give a little sharing.
Time.
Yeah, I know. I was looking for you there, but you never were there. You probably were doing some other caring missions elsewhere, weren't you?
Yeah, I was actually asleep, as I tend to be throughout the day.
Oh, that's right. Because the park is always open. The Care Bears did their show there in the daytime, and so you wouldn't be up for it. You weren't there. I wouldn't be there for a night show or anything.
No.
Oh, okay, but that's all really great. And that's, you know, I saw on the internet that you actually appeared with the Care Bears back in 2007 at the Chicago St. Patrick's Day Parade.
Yes, I did.
Mm-hmm. In fact, like I said, here's a picture of you on the float, you know, with all the other Care Bears. In fact, Tenderheart Bear was there, too.
Yes, he was.
Yeah. In fact, I also saw pictures of Good Luck Bear. You know, he was like the Grand Marshal of that parade, and there was like a picture of him turning the Chicago River green.
Yeah, that was quite a fun event. I sure had a lot of fun meeting all my fans and all the different Care Bears out there.
Uh-huh, yeah, you know, and so that must have been strange, seeing the river turn green. But then they say everybody's going green nowadays, huh?
Yes, I guess everybody is.
And green is Good Luck Bear's color, huh?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. A couple of years ago, you had a live touring show called Care Bears Live, didn't you?
Yes, we did.
Mm-hmm. That's right, and my friend Tenderheart Bear was like the star.
Yes, he was.
Yeah, and it was Star and Grumpy and Wish Bear were there, and they were all helping this little girl named Lindsay. Did you have any guests visit Caroline? Because I know she wanted to.
We've had some in the past. We actually had the Care Bear Fair not too long ago.
Ah.
You remember those?
Yes, I remember that. That was even seen in one of the cartoons on your TV show.
Yeah. We invite a bunch of kids to come up to Care-A-Lot, and then we go on all the rides and play some games and have lots of fun.
Oh, wow. Yes. And do you take them on the Thunderbolt? I know that's like Oopsie's favorite ride.
Yes, it is.
Uh-huh. Yeah, you know what my favorite ride is.
What's that?
Yeah. I like the merry-go-round with all the horsies. Yeah. I dream about horsies.
I know you do.
Oh, yeah, you do. Uh-huh. Do you visit other kids who dream about riding horses like I do?
I sure do.
Ah.
Grumpy Bear is also liking to ride horses and go on carousels.
Yeah. Grumpy builds carousels, but somehow they always seem to fly apart. At least they did in a couple of the movies, you know.
I'm not quite sure why that is.
I don't know. Something about something called the Framis inside, whatever that is. I can never figure out what that part is. I never heard of that before, and I know all about how carousels are built. I never heard of one with a Framis.
I don't know much about carousels either.
And in fact, you know, I've actually helped the Care Bears do a major appearance. I've helped the Care Bears appear in the annual Doodah Parade in Ocean City, New Jersey.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Tenderheart Bear appeared there. We've had Cheer Bear appear there once. We've had Wish Bear there a couple of times. And then recently, Love-A-Lot Bear is like to join the parade.
That must be a lot of fun.
That's right. You should come down and see it sometime.
Maybe I will. Maybe I'll come this year. When is it?
Well, okay. Usually it's the Saturday after Income Tax Day, which is April 15th. So therefore, it's usually the Saturday after April 15th, unless Easter, Passover, or Palm Sunday get too close to that date in the calendar. But yes, it's a lot of fun. And you know, I'm there with all my friends. All my volunteer mascot friends, and then also I also bring along the Care Bears.
I don't think I could ever forget that day. There is not as many nightmares as there is around tax day.
Oh yeah, I know that. Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, especially tax days. They're very pointy, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Oh, wait, no, that's a thumbtack. Sorry, my bad joke. Oh, boy. And that's, you know, you had a lot of, I've been to all your movies.
Have you?
Oh, yes. I've been to Care Bears. I've seen the Care Bears movie back in 1985, and then Care Bears 2, A New Generation, and then Adventures in Wonderland, and then there was like a long gap, and then until Journey to Joke-A-Lot came out.
Did you see the Care Bears Nutcracker?
Oh, yes, I did. That was actually a video. That was not technically not a movie. That actually came direct to video, and then it showed up on the Disney Channel a few times. And yes, in fact, there was a white rabbit in that movie.
Yes, there was.
Yes, you know, he's always late.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Ladies, late for a very important day.
Uh-huh. All right. In fact, speaking of Alice in Wonderland, I mean, I remember when I was a Tenderheart Bear one winter, and then we went up to the Alice in Wonderland statue in Central Park. And, you know, in fact, I even helped him make a music video about that. And,
oh, yeah?
That's right, and it's on YouTube.com.
I have to check that out.
That's right. Look up the YouTube channel Tenderheart Care Bear. It's one word, and you can see that music video along with some other nice music videos that Tenderheart Bear did. Although I actually helped him because I'm the one who knows how to do video. Oh, yes. Yeah. So how do you like New York Bedtime Bear? Because like I said, I know you haven't been here in like a long time here in New York. Except in Dreamland. Yes. Uh-huh. It is.
I love it. I love going to the Toys R Us store, the Disney store. Oh, there's so many awesome kids to meet. So many fans.
Oh, yeah, that's sweet. Now, the funny thing is, you know, like, they say New York City is a city that never sleeps, but I know you are...
That is certainly true.
Yes, right, but I know, on the other hand, you know that a good night's sleep is actually a very good thing to get, you know.
It's very important to get a good night's sleep.
Yeah, I mean, like, I know here in New York City, people are working all hours of the day or night, and sometimes I probably should be getting more sleep than I have been getting, or either that, or I feel I sleep too much, because I always have a lot of work to do, you know, but sleep is very important, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm, that's right, it helps you recharge.
And knowing where you're going around here, I'd be lost without you.
Oh, well, I'm always glad to, help you get around here in New York City. In fact, you know, when Tenor Art Fair travels around New York City, and I always lend him my Metro card for the subway.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's how he gets around. That's actually how he gets around, because I lend him my card. Yeah. You know, after all, like I said, I'm the rapid transit rabbit here.
That you are.
You remember that phase that Funshine Bear was going through when he was like a Joker? He saw himself as a Joker?
Yep.
Yeah, it wasn't quite like the Joker on the Batman movies.
No.
Uh-huh. Although, actually, I don't know if you actually know this, but way back in the years when the Care Bears were appearing at Dorney Park in Pennsylvania, Funshine Bear actually played a part called Joker Bear.
Really?
That's right, yeah. It was during the Care Bear Song and Dance Review, and Good Luck Bear was dressed up as Bat Bear.
Oh.
Right, yeah. So, yeah, in fact, hey, there's a little clip there of that.
Right there.
Yeah, look at that, you see? It's Bat Bear and Joker Bear. And he told the world's worst jokes, sometimes like me. must be a lot of work helping all those people get a good night's sleep, you know?
It really is. There's so many people in this world that need help getting good dreams and good sleep, good rest.
Yeah, and I'm glad you're there to help them, you know, because sometimes you can get lost pretty easily out there in dreamland.
Yes, you can.
Mm-hmm. There was once a song, Somewhere in Dreamland Tonight. That song was actually about an old amusement park that used to be in Coney Island here in New York City about 100 years ago. It's long gone, you know, but like unfortunately like a lot of old Coney Island is. But yeah, but I don't know if you ever heard that song. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, do you have any favorite bedtime songs or lullabies?
I think my favorite would be Tooraloora.
Ah, Tooraloora, Tooraloora. So Bedtime Bear, you know, it must be quite a huge job helping kids all over the world to get to sleep. I mean, how exactly do you do that? I mean, what are the things that sometimes make it hard for kids to get to sleep?
Well, that's a very good question, Rabbit. Actually, some kids are afraid of the dark or scary noises or even afraid of a new place they might be sleeping in at night. I can remember one time when Grumpy Bear came to me about a girl named Sally who was very grouchy during the day, and we couldn't figure out why. Turns out she was having a hard time getting a good night's sleep because of all the noises, and she was just so afraid of the dark.
Oh, was her apartment that noisy, or was it just like little things?
Well, it turns out that there was tree branches going up against the windows, making weird noises, and shadows from the clothes and stuff, making very scary pictures on the walls.
Oh, that's right. And in the dark, you know, like when shadows can be pretty spooky and scary, and they look bigger than they really are.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So how, you were able to fix those things for her?
Yeah, I was able to show her, actually, when I turned the lights on, what was actually making those noises and all those shadows.
Ah, no, nothing to really be afraid of.
Nope, there certainly wasn't, and as soon as she found out that everything was okay, she ended up getting a good night's sleep.
Ah, and then she was no longer grouchy.
Yeah.
Ah, okay, and I'm pretty sure that stopped some rumbly, and that stopped the Grumpy's tummy from rumbling.
Yeah.
Oh wow, that is really so sweet, you know. So you really do a great job. You're sort of like the night patrol for all these kids in Dreamland.
Yep. I'm your third shift Care Bear.
Okay, but that is really that's a really a wonderful job you do, and you know, like and that makes you a real special Care Bear. You're the only one who really really works at night and does all those caring missions.
It's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it.
Oh, yes, and that somebody is Bedtime Bear. Yeah. Do you ever have your own dreams sometimes? Do you have any favorite dreams of your own?
Yeah.
When you sleep? I mean, obviously you sleep in the daytime, but
my favorite dreams are when I go to amusement parks. I love going to amusement parks and riding on the carousels,
ah,
and the roller coasters.
Mm, me too. Yeah, I love.
Oh, and cotton candy.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. Do you ever have dreams of being a hero or like being a hero like a knight or a fireman or?
Yeah.
Uh huh.
I've had some dreams where I've been a knight before and have to face some evildoers.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And do you visit other kids in Dreamland who have those same kind of dreams?
Yeah. Sometimes I do.
Wow. Okay. Wow. That's amazing to be able to see what everybody's dreams are and everything, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's very special. Not everybody gets to see them, but I do.
Mm-hmm. Right. And at the same time, you fight off the stuff that nightmares are made of, right?
Yep.
You turn bad dreams into good dreams.
Yes, I do.
Ah. Wow. That's. Wow, you know, bedtime, with all the hard work that you and all the other care bears do, I mean, do you guys ever need a break? Because that's mostly a lot of hard work, helping everybody share their feelings all over the world all the time, you know?
Yeah, it really does get tiring after a while, but, you know, all of us care bears need a rest at some point.
That's right, so you guys actually did go into hibernation for a few years, didn't you?
Yeah, we did.
Mm-hmm.
We certainly did.
Yeah, but then I was there to help welcome you guys when you came out of hibernation in Times Square.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. That's right. See, there, look back here. See, look, there's Tenderheart Bear and Funshine Bear and Cheer Bear coming out. Look at that. Wow. And like, but it looks like, and they look pretty well rested there, don't they?
They sure do.
Yeah. Uh huh. So and then a couple of years ago, all you Care Bears celebrated your 25th anniversary again.
Yes, we did.
That's right. Again, right there in Times Square here in New York City. Look at that. See, you guys are all arriving in pedicabs and introducing your newest Care Bear, Oopsie Bear.
Yeah, Oopsie's a fun guy.
Yeah, he is.
A little clumsy.
I mean, sometimes we all are that way, but
yeah.
He kind of showed that it's okay to be clumsy as long as you, you know, you don't cause too much damage or repair any damage that you actually do. Yeah, and he really means well. He always means well.
Yes,
well.
He does. He always means well.
Yeah. So you think someday Oopsie Bear will get a real tummy symbol?
I think so. He's working towards it.
Yeah, that's right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then so one day he'll actually earn his a real tummy symbol.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or sometimes, he calls it belly badge, but we know what they're really called.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, it was also something that, you know, the Care Bears, you know, you Care Bears celebrated your 25th anniversary approximately the same time that I celebrated my 25th anniversary on cable television here in New York.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's congratulations.
Oh, thank you. You know, I'm already, all right, back this year, 2009, I passed my 26th anniversary, so I'm even one year past that now.
Okay. That's a long time.
Yeah. Yes, but I'm proud to have all you Care Bears on my show, at least some of you who are able to, especially Tenderheart Bear, you know. Tenderheart Bear and I have really been good friends for a long time. He's been a very special inspiration to me, as all you Care Bears are. But, you know, Tenderheart Bear is the one I get to see all of more most often.
He talks a lot about you.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Yeah.
Aww.
He says you're a great dancer.
Sort of. Well, but you know, again, I take a lot of cues from Tenderheart Bear. I look up to Tenderheart Bear as a role model.
I think we all do. I know I do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sort of. He used to be the de facto leader of the Care Bears, right? But he pretty much gave that up, didn't he? He sort of like wanted stuff that everybody should take charge every now and then.
Yeah, I don't think it's that so much that he gave up, but he just wanted to give some other people a chance to.
Oh, that's what I meant. Yes, you know,
yeah.
Give everybody. Yeah, you know, so you know, the Care Bears don't necessarily have to have a leader.
No.
Although I remember the cousins, that Braveheart. Remember Braveheart Line? He was the leader of the Care Bear cousins. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I know you like to talk to the fans and out there on the internet because there are actually a lot not many people know about, but there are a whole bunch of bulletin boards for Care Bear fans to like you know post little notes about well about their love for the Care Bears, all of you guys, right?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. They like to collect the toys and things like that, but and also like
and the movies
and everything. Yeah. And in fact, you know, yeah. Have you ever seen some of those websites? Like I said, they talk a lot.
I have.
Yeah, that's right. You know, in fact, we can actually give the websites on this show the address. Like, in there's SwiftHeartRabbit.net. Okay, and then there's ForestOfFeelings.com. And guess what? There's even a website called Planet Care Bears, but their address is actually BedtimeBear.com.
Oh!
That's right. So you actually have a website address named after you.
Really?
Yeah, that's right. Although it's really called Planet Care Bears, but that's the address is BedtimeBear.com, you know. And in fact, the owner of that website is actually here in New York City, you know.
Really?
He's another fan by the name of Rabbit. No relation to me, but because I'm Rabbit. T Rabbit, and his name is just Rabbit, but he runs Planet Care Bear. Well, so there are a lot of fans out there, you know, a lot of longtime fans, and of course the longtime fans also inspire new fans, right?
That they do.
Mm-hmm. Well, Bedtime Bear, I really want to thank you for being my guest here on today's edition of the Rabbit T Rabbit Show. You know, I really love you Care Bears, all of you Care Bears there, and you know, and again, my thanks to Tender Heart Bear for helping me out and inspiring me. And also all you bears up there in Carolot, and also the Care Bear cousins too.
You're welcome, Rapid. Anytime.
Mm-hmm. Oh well. Anyway, so I guess. We're taping this in the daytime, so I'm pretty sure you're gonna have to get some more rest before you go on duty back tonight. Yeah. Okay. Well. Bedtime. You get some more rest, and then before night falls. Okay. And then you're back on duty. Right. Okay. Anyway, I'd like to thank my friend Bedtime Bear of the Care Bears for being here, for being my guest today, and I thank you for joining us here on the Rabbit to Rabbit Show. And so until next time, keep hopping happy
and keep on caring. Bye.